Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 9.2, Problem 3. This is Section 9.2, it's problem number 3. It says a local dentist is interested in determining the average number of cavities for their adult patients over the age of 25. A random sample of 16 patients provides a sample mean of 10 cavities and a sample standard deviation of 4. Find a 95% confidence interval for the average number of cavities per patient. So, this is a confidence interval. We're going to use the confidence interval formula. So, we really have two confidence interval formulas, one for when you know the population standard deviation and one for when you do not. We know the standard deviation of the sample. So we have to use the confidence interval formula that is x bar plus or minus s, the sample standard deviation, over the square root of n, the size of the sample, times t sub c for the confidence coefficient. The other formula has a sigma here, the Greek letter, for the population standard deviation, and it's z sub c if we know the population standard deviation. Here we do not, and that's a more realistic case. So let's start filling this in. The x bar is the average of the sample, which the question tells us is 10. Plus or minus s, the standard deviation of the sample, which again, the question tells us is 4. Divided by square root of n. N is the size of the sample, and if you look, it says that a sample of 16 patients. So 16 is the size of the sample. Don't forget, it's under a square root, so it's square root of n becomes square root of 16. And now t sub c, the confidence coefficient. So we have to use the student's t distribution, which is attached at the end of the homework. And what we need to do is find the correct row and the correct column and see where that row and column intersect, and it'll give us the value of t sub c for this problem. So the column is determined by doing 1 minus the level of confidence as a decimal over 2. So for this particular problem, that would be 1 minus 95% confidence as a decimal is 1 minus 0.95, and it's over 2. 1 minus 0.95 is 0.05, and when we divide that by 2, it would be 0.025. That's the column of the chart to look in. Now we need to know the correct row. The row is easier. The row is the size of the sample minus 1, and this is labeled as DF for degrees of freedom. So if we have 16 in our sample, the degrees of freedom would be 15, one less. So I want to see where that 0.025 column intersects with the 15 degrees of freedom row, and they will intersect at a value of 2.131. That's our value of t sub c. So now we have the formula filled in. The x bar sample mean was 10. The s sample standard deviation was 4. The square root of n, square root of the sample size, was square root of 16. And the t sub c, the confidence coefficient for this, was 2.131 that we get from that chart. Now that it's filled in, it's just a matter of doing the math. If you make a mistake, it's more likely that you make it filling it in. Once you get to this point, if you have a calculator, you'll probably do all right. The first thing that you're going to need to do is deal with that square root. So let me write that as 10 plus or minus 4 over square root of 16 is 4, because 4 times 4 is 16, times 2.131. That'll stay for now. Next, I can reduce 4 divided by 4. Simply reduces to 1, clearly. 10 plus or minus 1 times 2.131. And now, ordinarily, there's a multiplication that would occur here that I would need a calculator for, but 1 times 2.131 I can do in my head without a calculator. It'd be just stays 2.131, because times 1, it wouldn't change it. So I have 10 plus or minus 2.131. So now that I have 1 number value after my plus and minus symbol. This would be called the margin of error when you're down to that point where you have one number after the plus and minus. I can split into a separate plus and a separate minus. So my confidence interval will have a low end of 10 minus the margin of error, 10 minus 1.31, to an upper end of my interval of 10 plus the margin of error, 10 plus 2.131 for this particular case. So on the small end, when I subtract 10 minus 2.131, that'll be 7.869, the low end of my interval. And the upper end, 10 plus 2.131, will come to 12.131. So that's where the average number of cavities, the true average, if the dentist could examine all their patients that they have, all their adult patients over the age of 25, the dentist would be 95% sure that this is an interval where the true population average would be, based on one sample of only 16 patients.